Depending on your background, you might want to edit in your other NLE and complete your program in Autodesk Smoke. In this video, I'll show you how to do a standard conform of your sequences. Please bear in mind that it is also possible to do all your editing in Autodesk Smoke. Editorial functions will be covered in later videos. Whether you're working with Apple Final Cut Pro 7 or Apple Final Cut Pro 10, first you need to export an XML. If you're working with Avid Media Composer, you need to export an AAF. Smoke supports both these formats and is able to rebuild the sequences from the other editing applications. With regards to media such as video sources, you may choose to work with the native media or cached intermediates coming from your other NLE. For example, you could have edited using Apple ProRes, and now you want to edit with native R3D files. Or perhaps you consolidated and transcoded your original media to DNxHD, and you want to choose to either use the original media or the DNxHD intermediates. The conforming tools in Smoke will give you all these choices when conforming your sequence. Let's focus on a basic conform example. You have been working in your other NLE, and you have simply exported an AAF or XML. The media exists at various locations on your drives and your network, but none of the media has been moved around. So this would be a typical job where everything is done on one workstation. In Smoke, you'll start off by switching to the Conform tab. This interface will eventually display your sequence at the bottom of the screen, and it will also display an event list containing every source clip used in the active sequence. To begin the process of importing your AAF or XML, go to the Media Library and choose a folder as the destination for the sequence clip. You can always move the sequence clip to another folder at a later time if desired. Right-click over the event list, and you can choose to load a new XML, AAF, or EDL file. In the file browser, you can navigate to the folder location where you exported your sequences. In my case, I exported AXML into a folder, and the media is located in the surrounding subfolders. Double-clicking on the XML file will bring up the preview player with any embedded information. Just as a side note, when you import media into Smoke, you can choose to work with the native files or tell Smoke to create its own cached versions of the media. This step also applies to the conform, where you can choose how your footage is managed by Smoke as it rebuilds your sequence. Just switch to the General tab, and if cache source media is disabled, Smoke will work with the native media. If you enable this option, Smoke will transcode the footage into optimized media. In this case, I want to work with the native media, so I'll ensure the option is turned off. Now switch to the AAF and XML import options. There are two search mechanisms that Smoke uses to find media when you import an AAF or XML: absolute searching and relative searching. The absolute search performs a scan inside the XML or AAF. The XML or AAF formats store the import locations of the media files on your system. So the absolute search always refers back to the original paths of the media as per the XML or AAF. The relative search makes Smoke look around at the other folders and subfolders close to the AAF or XML location. So relative scans the surrounding folders for potential media to match the sequence. So if you're on a different system and the media is moved, the file paths will be different. This invalidates the absolute file paths in the XML or AAF. Therefore, you need to use the relative search to find the media. Just know that Smoke will always perform an absolute search, but you can always disable relative searching if you want. However, it doesn't hurt to leave all the search options on in order to find the media in the initial search. The link to media files is always enabled by default. As Smoke constructs the sequence, it will automatically link to the original media. The preferred media option is more specific to Avid Media Composer. using original sources, connects the AAF to the original files. Using the offline intermediates, connects the AAF to the transcoded DNxHD files from the Avid Media Composer. Once your settings are ready, you can start the conform process and Smoke will rebuild the sequence and start looking for the media. You will get a progress message at the bottom of the interface. Once the process is complete, you will see the sequence clip in the library folder. There is also an option to create a subfolder with all the sources used in the conform sequence. If the sequence is not already open, right-click it and choose to open it as the active sequence. The event list will populate itself with all the entries from the open sequence. You will notice that the status of each clip is linked, indicated by the chain icon. When you click on each entry, the positioner in the sequence will jump to that particular segment matching its source's entry. So you can verify each source has been found and the conform has been successful. Now you can switch to the Timeline tab and begin your work in Smoke. Please consult the Autodesk Help resources for the list of supported effects coming from AAF and XML sequences. Please move on to the next video to continue your Smoke Getting Started experience.